boys and girls. It's Aunt Pelumi here today, and I'm so excited to bring God's word to you today. It's another lovely Sunday, and it's time where we learn about God and have some good fun. All right? So, who can show me the biggest smile? Okay, I hope your smile was as wide as mine. And children, don't ever forget, you're wonderfully and fearfully made by God. So today, guys, we're going to be learning about the Jordan River in Joshua chapter 3. When Moses died, God chose Joshua to be the next leader of the Israelites and was going to lead them into the promised land that is called Canaan. But before they get to the promised land, they would have to face some big problems, like crossing the Jordan River. But before we go on, guys, let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you very much for bringing us to another Sunday service. Lord, thank you for how you've been with us and how you've protected us. Lord, we pray that even as we learn about you today, that you will teach us from your word and that you will be with us even as we learn today. In Jesus' name. And everybody says, Amen. All right, guys, who's ready to dance and praise the Lord? Because I am. Okay, let's go.
So mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, he made the seas, he made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
I hope you enjoyed singing and dancing and praising God. So, our story today.
Last week, we talked about Rahab and the two spies who had gone to check out the land God had promised them, Canaan. They came back to tell Joshua and the people of Israel good things about Canaan. So this means they could continue their journey to the promised land. But they would have to cross the River Jordan to get there. Now, in the days of Joshua, there were no boats or ships to travel on water. So then, how were the children of Israel going to cross the Jordan River? Well, let's see. So the next morning, while the Israelites were traveling, Joshua brought them to the Jordan. They stayed there for 3 days. The leaders then gave orders by saying,
"Everyone, follow the priest when you see them carry the Ark of the Covenant."
Joshua told the Israelites they have to be holy because God wanted to do amazing things the next day. The next day, Joshua told the priest to carry the Ark and start walking to the Jordan River. The river was in flood and dangerous to cross. God then said to Joshua,
tell the priests who are carrying the ark to stand in the river when they get to its edge.
As soon as the priest's feet touch the water's edge, guess what? The water stopped flowing. It piled up in a heap a great distance away. There was now dry ground in the middle of the Jordan River where the priest stayed. So every one of the Israelites crossed over safely on dry ground, facing Jericho. The cool thing was that there was not a single wet foot. How amazing is that? After that, God told Joshua to select 12 men from the 12 tribes of Israel to set up stones where they would camp. This would help them remind their kids about God's miracle of helping them cross the River Jordan.
Okay guys, who is ready to select 12 stones from our River Jordan? Just like the 12 men of Israel did. I am. Alright, count with me. We're going to count 12 stones. Here is one stone, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So we're going to set it up just like the children of Israel did. That was going to help them remember to tell their kids about this big miracle of God helping them go through the River Jordan on dry land.
After this, the priest came up from the water as instructed by Joshua. The waters of the Jordan started flowing again just as they did before.
So kids, from this interesting story, we can see that even though the River Jordan had lots and lots of water at that time, and it was going to be so dangerous for them to cross, God still helped the Israelites stop the water so they could walk on dry ground. Remember, God helped them to do a miracle like this when they had to walk through the Red Sea when Moses was alive. So kids, I want you to remember today that whenever we face a difficult problem, God is always there for us, and we can always trust Him and talk to Him about it, because He always hears and answers our prayers. Amen. Our memory verse is going to be from Matthew chapter 19, verse 26. Let's go again. Matthew chapter 19, verse 26. But Jesus looked at them and said, "With man, this is not possible, but with God, all things are possible." Let's go again. Matthew chapter 19, verse 26. Jesus looked at them and said, "With man, this is not possible, but with God, all things are possible." Praise the Lord. Amen. Alright guys, I hate to go, but we've come to the end of our video for today. Remember, God is always there for us whenever we need Him and whenever we have a difficult situation to face. Okay? Let us pray. God, thank you very much for teaching us today that we can always trust you and rely on you to hear and answer our prayers. Lord, help us to always talk to you whenever we have any problems, and help us to trust you and put our faith in you. Go before us this week, Lord, and bless us, protect us and our families, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, guys, I hate to go, but I will definitely see you again next time. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.